Hey guys, Tyro here, bring you a one-for-one today. We are on Angerville. And this one is between Sears and the Sears, spawning in the south. As US forces, selected rifle company straight away. Not a bad idea, considering you can bring in the elite rifleman, usually after your second rifle squad. And he'll be facing off against Scott as an astronaut. A very highly ranked player, often in the, pretty much always in the top 50, maybe in the top 10 every now and then as well. Wow, look at that capping spot. Just in that.
Rifle squad ready for action.
Nice positioning there by God as an astronaut, or Gia.
Target secure.
As he's sometimes... His name is abbreviated too. Who's playing as OKW? And we have breakthrough, Luftwaffe ground forces, and fortifications. Fortifications can go on all right on this map. It's not really that popular of a doctrine these days, but sometimes you can put it in this sector here from this spawn and pretty much lock down at least like this this section of the map here. And then stall for Panther or whatever else you choose to stall for. So it's slightly more viable on this map than some of the other ones. Some engagement here, Stern Pioneers closing the close range of the riflemen. They took quite a lot of damage straight away. And the rifles do win that. They were stationary as the Stern Pioneers advanced. Meaning they're more accurate with their rifles. And blasted them with no trouble. Rifle now a bit low health, and looks like Gia's going to try to do some pushing with his SWS. Not really much trouble going down, not enough troops here to really put some hurt on it. A bit more background on this map. It's actually a friendly 1v1, not a ladder match or a tournament match, just a scrum. Pre-arranged match, and she is the live stream, and they're actually both on TeamSpeak with each other. Not really taunting each other or anything like that, but just making the odd comment every now and then about what happened and what they thought should be going on. Yeah, so tough for OKW to get a rifleman squad out of a building. Looks like Gia's not really just even worrying about it, he's just going to leave this one squad here to try and go blow for blow between these buildings. And he's actually selected Breakthrough, so I imagine he's going to be fielding some fusiliers at some point. Interesting, he hasn't connected his cutoff here. Maybe he's hoping to grab this point here. Connect the resources on the left-hand side of the map in that fashion. It's going to be hard though with this garrison under control of Sears, and so is this one. Looks like rifles are pulling ahead in this engagement, slowly but surely. Rifles forced away from the left-hand side though. So it looks like Gia's maybe going to try focus a bit more of his efforts over there. He's got two squads there at the moment. Of course, not to confuse Gia with Gia, or Gia, the Vietnamese player. Goes astronaut is from Germany, I believe. Both very excellent players. Looks like these troops trying to brute force this Volksunity squad out of this garrison here. Doing pretty well. Looks like folks are maybe firing at the rear echelons instead of the riflemen. Yeah. Now doing very little damage to them even. Tried a bit of a juke maneuver there.
I'm so
maybe hoping to catch those squads out of cover for a second, but doesn't really work out too well. Engagement over here, riflemen playing heavy cover, but they had a bit of a health disadvantage and forced to retreat. Here comes some fusiliers. Actually see no veteran riflemen called in by Sears. He's gone for four rifles into lieutenant. And actually he didn't have enough fuel to go for his scout car any earlier. So Gia had excellent fuel control in the early game. And there's accordingly we see him like a rather late in training. I imagine at this point Gia's probably thinking he's going to be seeing the anti-aircraft half-track. But no, it will be the M20. Sears has had to make a full retreat from the right hand side of the map, and he's branching out to the left now with his lieutenant and a rifle squad. So these Fox Rangers are going to try hold up behind the sandbag position, see if they can halt that advance. Maybe able to slow it, but they will ultimately lose to the superior numbers. FCN20 going to try flush these fusiliers out of the building. And they decide to jump out anyway. Does it have armor skirts? Yep. Just completed now. So it's not too much of a risk against small arms fire. Here comes the lieutenant. But actually there's a second set of Fox Rangers over here now. And the lieutenant may actually lose. Force this squad to retreat, but it's taken about a third of its health and damage. M20 still trying to force the squad out. This rifle squad incredibly low, but luckily Sears has already made an ambulance, so that won't be too much of a trouble. I think these lieutenants barely taken any model losses so far. Now with the support of the rear echelons, those Volkswagens are going to have to retreat from the left, so that's a bit of a upset there. I wasn't expecting that. Thought that the lieutenant would have lost the engagement, but just quite low in health, but didn't drop any models, so its DPS was actually quite high. And the Volkswagens were just not very. Well, their just DPS is pretty rubbish anyway, so. Prepare yourself. Cover the approaches. The squad is back to full strength. Dynamic play by both switching sides, left and right, right and left. Nice flow to this match so far. Two squads of fusiliers coming in from Gia. He's actually fielded a Shrek and of course a Rickenwerfer, which is trying to position itself to blast away at the M20. Rickenwerfer is not too bad. I mean, there's plenty of garrisons for it to jump into on this map, so you actually get to use that feature, at least on the right hand side of the map. Ooh, nice quick reaction time here from Sears. Quickly pop smoke on the M20, stopping the Rickenwerfer from launching a shot. Looks like riflemen are spreading across the right again. Looks like these fusiliers are maybe trying to ambush, coming through this little gap here. But there's two squads of riflemen here, and they will lose. Sandwich between those two squads. Oh, he tries to throw a grenade over the hedge into the heavy cover position, but the riflemen aren't there. So that was just a waste of munitions, unfortunate for Gia. What's going on over here? Fusiliers capping the left now. M20 over here though. And there's not much they can do. They could throw an anti-tank grenade, but without a Shrek to follow up, it's just going to be a waste of munitions also. He doesn't have any munitions left in fact, so he can't do that. So he's probably going to have to make a full retreat from the left hand side of the map. Rifles engaging Fox Rangers. 2v1 though, Fox Rangers win that. Stim Pioneers try and flush rifles out of this garrison, having a little bit of success. Got a good hit calls up from Gia, so we're not I haven't seen any flak after I get yet, which is usually the more popular option these days with OKW. Quite just a bit of capping going on, we can see here on the tactical map. So we see tech structure, Shreer HQ going over here. So that's on the cutoff point here, so it's going to prevent Sears from doing any flanks through here and cutting off this sector. Or this right hand flank of the map at least.
Our resource sector has been cut off from our supply chain.
Oh, here comes a big push, lots of fusiliers and one Fox Media squad. It's lieutenant and rifles. Rifles quickly drop. This fusilier squad is also quickly dropping. Uh-oh. Should be alright. And both of the lieutenants should stick around against fusiliers and Fox Media. Oh, nade just, oh my god, did nothing at all. What? Okay. M20 moves to support now. No Shrek on this squad, so they're going to have limited success against that M20. And that Shreer headquarter does get found out by Sears' rifleman there, trying to go for the cutoff, but was unsuccessful. And here comes a Luke's from Gia. That's why he's choosing to make his first vehicle fuel purchase on. I'm surprised he didn't go for the Kubelwagen. It's usually pretty good on this map. Oh, actually, here we go. Sears has ticked both lieutenant and captain, so there's some Zooks here to try and blast away at this Panzer II. And if it takes engine damage, it looks like it's going to go down now. Oh, that captain has got bazookas, have got pretty rubbish accuracy at long range, so. Oh, he's just trying to kite it. Oh, and that captain squad gets wiped! Anti-tank grenade finishes the job. Yeah, that looks was not long for this world. Pretty good position for it, though. It can quite easily be salvaged by GS, so. All is not lost, and he did take out that captain squad, so I think certainly could have gone worse. Looks like Fusiliers may try a rifle grenade on this M20. I can't fit through this arch here. And there was that Rick Kenworth here set up. Oh, here comes a big old blob from Sears. It's going to be impossible for even this squad and the garrison to stop. Gonna have to retreat. Oh, Vic 2 rifle side doing nasty damage to those Fox Rangers straight away. Still, Gia has managed to take most of the left hand side of the map while all this is going on the right. All the resource points, basically, anyway. Not the victory point. You can see CS has what is that? 80 point advantage at the moment? 100 point advantage, in fact. Why? What is up with my mess? M20 just inflicting some damage onto these squads while they retreat. Fresh captain from Sears. Interesting choice. Guess he wants those bazookas. How much does he cost to rebuild? 320.
The enemy is overrunning 320
for two zooks. That's okay. If you want to save your fuel. And he does want to save his fuel. He desperately wants to save up for an EZ-8. G Gia has been doing excellent fuel harassment so far this match. Which, even after the slightly more expensive teching route from Gia and the structure, and not the structure, the Luke's, which is more expensive than the N20 in terms of fuel, he actually pretty close in terms of fuel, especially considering the OKW resource penalty. So Gia's definitely been doing a pretty good job of holding onto resources so far. I wonder if that must be bars ticked up by Sears. And that squad's got two bars, so that's a Terminator squad there. They're doing a heap of damage. Good idea to retreat on them early though, you don't want to lose one of those bars. Second bar on the Lieutenant squad as well, okay. That's going to be a very nasty squad. Oh, Shrek's Knight! And that forces a retreat. Once more, EM20 trips into the left hand side. Going to try to flush out those Fusiliers. See, first squad at Opusol done running onto the map now from Gia. Here comes the Raketenwerfer. Squad of the Echelons here as well, which is taking a bit of damage. Raketenwerfer is trying to make an aggressive play and run after the M20, which you can kind of afford to do with the Raketenwerfer, seeing as it can actually retreat, unlike other anti-tank guns. You can be a bit more bold with it, knowing that you can retreat. You have that in your back pocket. It's good because a bit rubbish in most other respects. Field promotion. Enemy infantry. Jeez, trying to make this a stronghold, and wow, that grenade was nasty. Here comes some rifle squad from the right hand side through this archway, doing a whole heap of damage to this garrison here. Overstall down here, no LMG on them yet, but they're pretty good anyway. Here comes the first Easy 8 running straight through the wall. Kenworth is set up back here. One shot off, and Shrek gets one shot off as well, that Easy 8. Looks like it's going to pull back for some repairs, maybe. Yep, he's going to use the vehicle crew to cap whilst repairing this. Maybe, maybe not. Looks like he wants that squad of riflemen there as a buffer, just in case something tries to snipe the vehicle crew, which is understandable. Losing your first Easy 8 would be a disaster. A lot of troops reinforcing and healing back here for Gia. Similarly, Sears is now pushing out from his base with a large force going to the left. So get a bit of follow action going in. A bit of cinematics.
A capture point is being overrun. Reinforcements area is ours.
Oh, I spotted a fusilier on the horizon. Riflemen engaging from range against these. Fortunately, it is in the sandbag position. Looks like they may stick around to at least decap that fuel. Not sure how much longer they'll stay though. Doing pretty good, they haven't really taken much damage at all so far. Oh, but here comes Easy 8! Oh, he's stuck around for too long and his retreat is a bit slow. Kenworth are here to cover its retreat though, and he's lucky that that shell only knocked out one of the two remaining squad members. Overs now have the LMG, doing pretty good damage to this lieutenant with a double bar. Attempts. Oh, that was a nasty hit though. Looks like that squad may have had two Shreks as well. Wow. It's a big bloke. Obers are desperately trying to hold on against these two rifleman squads. And they're doing alright. A couple of nice bursts off there. Shrek squad coming from the flank on the EZ-8. And that will pull away to safety at the same time. G's doing a bit of capping here, and so is Sears. The squad's got some bars, but that squad is Vet 4, so not sure who's going to win this one. Probably the double bars. Should be. No, grenade. Oh, that was a slow toss. Oh, it was a slightly late reaction though from Gia, so she did quite a lot of damage. M20 doing a bit of pushing here, trying to do some damage. Nice positioning from this Rickenwerfer though. Gia's been really active with this Rickenwerfer, getting it in all the right spots at all the right times. He's been doing a really good job with that. I'm quite impressed.
Unit ready. Jagdpanzer has arrived.
Maybe you should try to use this camouflage ability and try spring some ambushes on Sears's vehicles. Here comes a Jagdpanzer, in fact, from Gia. So that should maybe swing things back in Gia's favour. This left-hand side is pretty much made for the Jagdpanzer. Lots of wide open spaces. It's so easy to target these easy eights and so forth.
We're losing a capture point.
M20's in a bit of trouble. These two squads with... Oh my god, and that was bad luck there from Gia. That Shrek just hit the fence line there. M20 might have been in serious trouble otherwise. So he quickly gets it out of there. Second set of Obers, in fact. Trying to cap on the right hand side. Another brute force attempt by Sears to try and get the squad out. Well, in fact, he's got grenades now, so he doesn't really need to brute force. He can just lob a pineapple in there. Man, these buildings are so durable, though. All these structures on the right-hand side of the map can really take a good walloping before they go down. M20 trying to do some damage again. Takes one Shriek shot first. Here comes Easy 8. It's got 50 cal upgraded on it now. And that's the second loot from Gia. That's a surprise. And that's gonna pump away at this squad here and this garrison. They decide to de-crew. Ooh, that's a nasty volley there. Did about half that rifleman's health. Looks like the squad wants to get garrison here. The squad now Vet 5. Wow, Vet 5 and didn't even have the G43 upgrades. It's just all natty. See it sprinting around. Yourself combat. Here comes the M1 trying to find a line on this loot, but it's out of position coming down this road here. Can it go down to fusilier fire? And it does. EZ-8's managed to force that vetted up squad to retreat, which continues to work on this squad. Well, takes a rifle grenade and captain's coming to try to finish the job. There's a Kenworth to set up in this alleyway though. Easy 8 can't come down here, takes one shot from the Rakima with her. May take a Faust soon. No, I mean a trick soon. Jag Panzer, ooh, gets one shot off. Bit slow on the chase though. And, oh, nice use of smoke there by the M20 covering its retreat path. Nice synergy there between the two vehicles, and that Easy 8 will get away on just about nothing. So we can see Gia has a huge amount of the map under control, the whole left, and he's about to take the whole right as well. But he, wow, he got super out of position with that squad. I think he's trying to go in for the kill, maybe hoping that the Easy 8 was in a easy position to snipe. But it wasn't. Look at all this variancy on all these squads from both players. Nice preservation so far. The Panzer are blasting away at the M1, wants to knock that out. Looks like Riechon's made crew it in time though. And the Jagdpanzer is not going to be able to knock it out. He's now retreating. He doesn't want to take a rifle grenade. Flamethrower's upgraded on this squad, and they're trying to do a bit of damage to the Ogres. It's the first set of flamethrowers so far this game, though. See, this has been going for all the bars mainly. Oh, this is a nasty formation of infantry. Turning this garrison again. Bazooka. Oh, you can say that was Fusilier squad. Interesting. It's going to be a very durable squad. Bazooka and Shrek 2D Easy 8 does quite a bit of damage. There's another Zook shot. And 20 doing some damage. Rifleman slightly overextended there, but retreat with plenty of time to spare. See, he's trying to do some frontline repairs on that M1 anti-tank gun, doesn't want to lose that for no good reason. The next fighter was super low in that Jagdpanzer fight. Uh oh, looks stopped for some reason. Maybe he's trying to bait that Easy 8. Easy 8 pops smoke, but there's still this squad here with the Shrek. May knock it out. Oh, it fails to penetrate. And the Easy 8. Oh my god, knocks it out. They're all clumped up right in this little corner here. And now Sturm Pioneers, in fact. Pick that trick up, so I suppose it could have gone slightly worse there. Oh, it looks like the M20 got abandoned there as well, and they dropped their bazooka on the ground. So wow, Sears has had some excellent luck there, M20 getting abandoned and Easy 8 bouncing that final Shrek shot. G continues to lock down the left-hand side of the map.
Our supply line's
he's going to be
heavy.
He's going to be careful because those are both Obersoldaten squads over there. And as soon as Caesar's vehicles have been repaired, that's going to be the first place he runs to. He needs some AT over there if he wants to hold on to that side of the map. Luke's chasing away that lieutenant squad. Sears is really in a bit of trouble, but he's managed to hold on to both his Easy 8s. So despite his rather poor map control, it's not over yet. If he'd lost that Easy 8, he would be in a much much worse position because Gia is getting pretty close to being able to afford a Panther now. One Easy 8 versus a Panther and a Yak Panzer, that would be trouble. A lot of trouble. As well as all these Shrieks and so forth. I think Sears would be in a lot of trouble if that was the case. Obers continue to operate on the left. Here come the two Easy 8s though, and one squad with the Shriek is not going to cut the mustard. Against two Easy 8s. Looks like Sears is going to push across the left now. Wow, this squad's almost at Vet 5 as well. Now it's got that Zook, will be doing lots of damage and helping it vet up even faster. Now its anti-infantry firepower will be slightly decreased. Yagpanzer trying to fire at range. Kenworth is set up here as well. Shrek misses. Yagpanzer's not going to be able to finish the job on that Easy 8. Switching sides, it's only on half health though, and this squad does have bazooka and anti-tank rifle grenade. Decides to retreat immediately though, because it actually fired this bazooka at that retreating squad there, so it would have been a while before it reloaded. I can understand that play from Gia. You don't want to risk losing it in the meantime. A bit bold with his Jagdpanzer though. If that takes an anti-tank grenade, that would be disastrous. And there's actually an M1 anti-tank gun set up here. Luckily, it doesn't have a line of sight on that Jagdpanzer. So it looks like Gia's maybe trying to save his fuel. I mean, his manpower for a Panther. I imagine that's the case. Zook's looking to try chase away this rifle squad, and it's doing quite a lot of damage. Sees deploy smoke. Luke continues to attack through the attack ground through the smoke. Easy 8's approaching through the smoke. Maybe it's a risky play. There's a lot of squads here. Takes a AT grenade, maybe. No, nothing's going to throw that AT grenade. Big. Or decent sized formation of infantry coming across here from Sears. Probably send his rear echelons to do the capping and rifles to try and engage in the combat against that Fox Grenadier squad. Nigeria's continuing to bank. I guess he figures if he can save up enough fuel, maybe get a Yag Tiger or maybe the King Tiger. Things are going well for him. Grenade on the M1 clears it. Jagdpanzer is going to try and knock it out. It's that same M1 that got away on a sliver of health last time. Not so lucky this time. A lot of reinforcement and healing going on in both bases. Sears using both vehicle crews to try and repair tanks one at a time. This does give them the option, of course, of crewing this one and jumping to react emergency if something arrives. Arises. Reckon it should be alright. Jagdpanzer up to Vet 2 now. Stand Pioneers do have the repair upgrade package, so they should be repairing pretty decently quickly. Oh no! Down goes that Vet 5 Fusilier squad. They're treated off in this direction. That just went horribly. He may lose this squad as well. Oh, and they've got G43s upgraded on them. Oh, this is just going terribly for Gia. Here comes the Panther, in fact, so he just decide to go for the Panther. He still hasn't salvaged that Luke's over there, that's a surprise. The Kittenwerfer gets cleared by the EZ-8s. The A-Panther's trying to get over here to support. The A-Panther's got his rear armor exposed. Uh-oh. He's taking some bazookas. Took an AT grenade. Panther's here to support. There's Luke's. Luke's is coming up to support now as well. Sears pop smoke to try and cover his approach on the Panther. Panther's doing pretty good damage. The A-Panther's, oh, I can't believe this. It's bounces that shot. Bounces that shot. Oh my god, is this gonna get away? Bounces that bazooka shot. Oh no, and he may lose the captain on retreat. At the same time, all this infantry is trying to do damage in the back, and he does actually, he does lose the captain. Oh no. That was disastrous. The Seers. The Yakpans are super lucky, bouncing Zooks like it was nobody's business. And I think bounce, maybe that easy 8 shot missed, I don't know. Either missed or bounced. So, gonna wait on just about nothing. I suppose that's kind of a bit of karma there for Gia, because Sears' easy 8 got away with also a sliver of health. Bouncing a Shrek. RNG gives and RNG takes. So VPs are pretty much dead even at the moment, which is a surprise because I felt like Gia maybe had slightly better map control, but uh-oh, Panther's out of position. EZS coming in, they're pretty damn fast, these EZS, especially once they receive veterancy. Oh, and that Panther's going down for sure. No AT grenade from these Fusiliers either. I think the Panther would have gone down anyway, but maybe the Jagdpanzer could have chased. No, that's still being repaired. Oh, that's a big blow to Gia. I'm losing his Panther there. Yes. I think it's a Veterancy 2 that game. Yeah, navigate the battlefield with ease. So Vet 2, they gain that movement speed advantage. And you can see that they were really fast chasing that Panther down. That's how they managed to get behind it. And that's what's good about preserving your units. They actually gain some useful buffs. How about that? A third Easy 8 called in by Sears. So that's three Easy 8s against Vet 2, Jagdpanzer, and two Shriek squads left. And Kenwith is still here as well. It's been recruited though. Quite low on health as well. The weapon health is quite low, so probably want to repair that before bringing it back to the front lines. G43 is doing heaps of damage to those bars. Obi's here as well. EZX trying to chase down the Sternpire squad. Luke's is also having to retreat. Bounces, and I think he's actually going to lose that squad, maybe. He's doing some nice pushing with that EZ-8 there, and wow, that thing turned around and faced like so quickly, it looked like it was on fast forward. It's kind of going this direction, it turned around and started chasing so quickly. That was, I guess that's the veterancy buff. That was really surprising. Usually EZ-8s have a bit of trouble chasing down squads on retreat, but he does have the 50 cal upgrade on this one, so that certainly helps against retreating squads. Fresh Panther from Gia. Both shots missed there though, so He's off to a bad start. Stolen Rickenwerfer here. Tries to move up to fire on the Panther. Could use attack ground. Knight decides to disengage. Didn't have line of sight there. Stamplane is doing some repairs in the back. Oh, they weren't quite finished reinforcing though. All the anti-infantry squads, though, from GA on the left, so doesn't have much to deal with the infantry on the right, apart from that Luke's. It actually did a pretty admirable job, but now that Panther's a bit low as well, it took a couple of bazookas. So G's not going to be able to engage until that receives repairs. EZAT takes some damage from much rear armor. EZAT's doing some marauding plays. Trying to knock out some retreating infantry squads. They caught one man there. And Gia's actually down to just one squad of Volkskrieg. He's got munitions to burn right now. He's got a bit of manpower in the bank as well. He could really afford to maybe build another squad of Foxtrotters and put the Shrek on them. Just about, could do two squads of Foxtrotters with the Shreks, in fact. So either that or Kenworth is probably in order. He hasn't salvaged any of these wrecks either, which is a bit of a surprise. And he's a long way away in terms of fuel from his next vehicle. Unless he chooses Luke's, which I doubt he will. Probably wants another Panther to deal with all these easy eights. And with all those munitions, maybe he could chuck down some mines. I mean, certainly needs some method to immobilize these EZ-8s if he wants to contend with them with the Jagdpanzer. Maybe he wants them to be sitting in a nice position for the Jagdpanzer to fire upon them safely. Jagdpanzer's a bit out of position here though. It's all on its lonesome. Three EZ-8s here and the Panthers on the right. Like the M1's trying to fire upon it. Here comes the Panther rolling through the hedge. Kenworth is set up there. Jagdpanzer firing at the EZ-8s. Luke's goes down to Rickenwerfer. Shrek squad's trying to do some damage but it bounces. Jagdpanzer's coming through the smoke. This EZ-8's trying to flank it. Oh, and that's assault artillery, so that's what G is going to use all his munitions on. Wow, oh my god. C is so lucky. Main gun destroyed now on that EZ-8. Oh, man. So G has used just about all his munitions in that. I think that's 200. Is it 300? No, 200 for assault artillery. Almost paid off though. If it had taken out that Vet3 EZ-8, that definitely would have been worthwhile. But it didn't. So that's not so good. Actually, Sears does have a sweeper squad, so maybe mines wouldn't be the best use for his munitions. I haven't really been paying attention to if he's been active with that or not. Huge swarms of riflemen capturing the right hand side of the map. Vet 5 fusiliers holding on to the left.
deployment.
Enemy infantry!
VPs are still dead even. This is a really, really close match. Feels like Caesar's starting to amass a very large amount of easy eights though, and that could be difficult for Gia to overcome. Oh, you can see those Vet 4 Obers both blasting away at those squads, actually suppressing them. That's why they gain at Vet 4. They can do some suppression. I think at Vet 5 they gain healing and sprint.
Mission accomplished.
Enemy Panzer! Target secure!
Oh, Fusilier is out of position, going to be chased down by these Easy 8s. He's only got 50 cal upgraded on one of them though. Doesn't have enough munitions otherwise. Oh, and he gets it just before it got away to safety. Jagdpanzer, wow, Vet 4 now. Gets a couple shots off. But those Easy 8s are just going to retreat all the way back to do some healing and repairing. It's got all healed up now. Maybe it's at Vet 4 they're getting the healing. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Here's suppression. Bit of an angle on this one.
Target secure. Target captured. No enemy contact.
Four Easy 8s now. Gia has fielded his second Panther. It's under construction right now. The two Panthers and a Jagdpanzer versus an Easy 8. It's going to be a good fight. Easy 8 does have quite a bit more armor than the regular Sherman, so can bounce the odd shot, and certainly bounce the odd Panzerstreak shot, as we've seen so far. Flight deployed by CS, trying to keep this Vet 3 Sherman alive at any cost. In this case, the cost was 30 munitions. Nothing too devastating. And good smoke usage though on his Sherman so far, both offensively and defensively from Sears. Certainly something I'm pretty rubbish at making good use of on my Sherman tanks. Panther on the right hand side now. He has to be careful though, he doesn't want to get any one of his tanks off by itself, because looks like the AT grenade bounce, which is good luck, because the weight of four Easy 8s could knock out his tank very quickly. So both of them kind of have to blob their armor together now. It's pretty rare you get armor blobs in 1v1, so this is a good sight to see. Good preservation by both players. Raid coming in on the Shrier HQ. Just trying to build another Lux, and that will not complete. Panther coming in from the side here. He's maybe trying. I'm not sure what he's going to try to do. Sherman's getting pretty good luck penetrating the frontal armor of the Panther. Quite effectively there. Oh, that Sherman's got to get away on super low health. Panther's maybe moving up to try to finish the job, but there's too much here for him to do. I want to overcommit. get an AT grenade and lose your Panther, that would probably spell the end of the game right now. It's just such a large army of easy axes. Really just going to be so tough for Tia to deal with. I do see your one trick squad has been rebuilt by Gia, so he's doing that. He's actually building a second Sturm Pioneer now, which is a pretty good idea because this much armor on the field, you need the repairing power. Can't be like Sears and decrew all of the Shermans right next to each other and get some vehicle crew teamwork going on. We'll do it the old-fashioned way with some pioneers. It's an AT grenade, I imagine. So, whoa, that squad gets knocked out there. That was the fresh Volksgrenadier squad. Knocked out by the Easy Eights. And this is what I was saying about the teamwork repairs going on. It's keeping Sears' this armor on the field pretty much the entire game. He's got 3 stars of veterancy on 2 of those Easy Eights, making them especially naughty. Uh-oh! Yopans is out of position here. Trying to speak to safety. Trying to pop smoke to try and cover from these fire from these Panthers. Just getting lots of penetrating shots as well. Now they're switching targets to the rear armor of the Panthers. Panthers also got its rear armor exposed. Oh, 2 Panthers go down. Nice use of smoke there. Definitely made the micro in this battle a lot harder for Gia. Oh, and not even a single one of those Easy 8s actually goes down the engagement. That was really well played by Sears. And, Jagdpanzer got a bit over ambitious, and Gia's tanks weren't quite in full health at the beginning of the engagement. No mines, not enough supporting infantry there, and all of those tanks are going to get away on super low health. Oh, he actually does a crush maneuver there on the Sturm Pioneer squad. Just rubbing some salt into that wound. And Sears surrenders. That was really well played by Sears. He got a bit lucky on a couple of Sherman, main gun destroyed and bouncing a critical Panzer Schreck's shot, which helped him amass a large army of Easy 8s, and doing some excellent work in that final battle, sealing the game. On the other hand, Gia had a pretty damn strong opening as OKW, forcing Sears to make a really late scout cart and just generally holding on to points quite well, especially the fuel, which he managed really well. Did pretty well for armor at the start of the game, but that Easy Axe snowball just caught up with him in the end. Couldn't quite manage to knock any of them out, and that was too much overwhelming force. And that'll do. Well played by both players. If you'd like your game to be cast by me, details are in the video description below. Otherwise, I'll catch you for the next thrilling installment. Goodbye and good luck.